Good morning, children. Welcome to a story time. Today, our story will be Jesus prayed for help. And the memory verse for today, watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. And the scripture today, children, is coming from Matthew 26, 35 to 56, and John 18, 1 through 4. To teach that Jesus went through the Gethsemane experience because he loved us. That is what this story is telling us. The reason why Jesus went to Gethsemane and experienced what he experienced at the Passover. Jesus and his disciples had eaten the Passover supper, which was the last supper. Jesus would eat with the disciples. Judah had left. He was on his way to the priest to tell them where Jesus was. Jesus had told the story that he would die on the cross for their sin so they could go to heaven with him. Now the time had come. What a wonderful way for God to show his love for a rebellious world. And God is still showing us his love for a rebellious world, as he did back then. Jesus and his disciples walked through the streets and out of the city. It was still night and the moon was shining. They was on their way to the Garden of Gethsemane. Jesus often went there to pray. And when they came to the garden, Jesus said, "Stay while I pray." He took Peter, James, and John with him. He wanted the disciples to pray with him. "Stay awake with me," Jesus asked. "My heart is breaking with sorrow and sadness." Jesus still wants us to pray today for us, for ourselves, and for everyone, and for the whole world. He said, "Walk a little further," and he fell to his knees and prayed, "Father, if there be possible, don't let me go through the terrible suffering that lies ahead, but let your will be done, not mine." Jesus knew what was going to happen. Crucifixion was shameful and cruel, but worse still was the thought that he had never sinned and was being judged a sinner and treated as one. He was to blame for everybody's sin. There was no other way to deliver man from sin, penalty, and power. He prayed, "If it is possible, please don't let it happen." But he knew it must happen. If he was to give up now, there would be no hope, no salvation, and anybody. And that's why he said, "Your will be done, not mine." In spite of Jesus' need for them, the three disciples had fallen asleep. Peter, Jesus asked, "Could you not stay awake for 1 hour? Stay awake and pray that you may not give into temptation." Then he looked at them with gentle and compassion. "Your spirit is willing, but your body is weak," he said. Again, he left them, went away and prayed. He came back, and once more they had fallen asleep. Jesus went back and prayed the third time. The third time he returned, he found the disciples sleeping. "Are you still asleep?" he asked. Jesus knew what was ahead for him. He had wanted them to also ask God for help. And he told the disciples, "The time had come. I am betrayed into the hand of the evil man." And then suddenly the dark shadow of torchlight, a mob, including Roman soldiers, surged through the trees. and their sword glimpsing in the moonlight. And that's when the story on the board changed over. After they was awake, Jesus walked up to Jesus. Judah walked up to Jesus and kissed him. This was the sign that Judas had said, and he would give the soldier move forward to arrest Jesus. Peter was furious. He pulled out a sword. And then Jesus said firmly, if I wished to be free, I could call an army of angels to fight. But I am ready to give up my life according to God's plan. And Jesus gently touched the man's ear and healed him. The frightened disciple watched Jesus allow the soldier to take him away in panic, despair. The disciple deserted Jesus and fled. If you had been in the garden that night, what do you think you would have done? So now the children is going to change the board for the second part of the story. And after that, we have worksheets and coloring sheets for the children to take, and they can color and do the worksheets and the puzzles. And this worksheets and the puzzle is pertaining to the story that we just read about Jesus praying for help. Now we will say a prayer. Lord, we thank you for this lesson that we had today. And we will continue to pray for Jesus' help as we go through the week, children. Make sure you say a prayer that Jesus will help you in school and at home, wherever you may be. Amen.